With the quarantine restrictions resulting from the coronavirus pandemic, some people wonder if the inactivity will make them even fatter. Actually, I believe that this is a great opportunity to get adapted to one meal a day and actually lose weight. Better yet, you may bolster your immune system that will help you resist the coronavirus infection through autophagy. I will show you how, with a home-based workout routine while fasted, will stimulate autophagy, the cellular recycling mechanism. So stick around, you don't want to miss anything. Hi, this is Juan Sarmiento. Over the last 10 years, I have adopted one meal a day, or OMAD, as an essential part of my daily routine. It is a lifestyle, really. It turns out that this approach may stimulate autophagy, and this might help resist the coronavirus infection. Let me show you what you can do during this quarantine period to change your life for the better. But before I do that, don't forget to subscribe to this YouTube channel. Also, click on the bell so you don't miss any of the videos coming up. With the pandemic outbreak of coronavirus disease 2019, or COVID-19 for short, I was reminded that autophagy is stimulated by OMAD. Autophagy may protect against viral infection, and we can stimulate autophagy. High-intensity training, when done in the fasted state, also stimulates autophagy. Other forms of extended fasting can do it too, including 1. Alternative day fasting with up to 36 hours of fasting. 2. One meal every other day with up to 48 hours of fasting. And 3. Extended fasting for a week or more. The goal of longer fasting is to stimulate autophagy as a means of cleansing the body from toxins. Autophagy is the intracellular recycling mechanism. Damaged organelles, proteins, and even some bacteria and viruses are engulfed by a double membrane vesicle, DMV, that forms the phagophore. Eventually, the gap is closed, forming an autophagosome. In the cell, there is a lysosome, a vesicle containing the chemicals capable of digesting the engulfed material. The lysosome and the autophagosome join together in an appropriately named body called the autolysosome. In it, chemicals or enzymes degrade the unwanted material, recycling amino acids into the cell. These amino acids may be used to build new proteins and organelles as needed. Autophagy's main role is to maintain cellular homeostasis. Our innate immune system activates autophagy as the first line of defense to degrade and dispose of invading viruses. In later stages of infection, autophagy facilitates antigen processing and thereby the induction of adaptive immune responses. In simple words, autophagy is a critical part of our defense against viruses. It plays a role whether we have been previously exposed or vaccinated, or neither. Unfortunately, some viruses, and coronavirus in particular, have evolved to hijack or evade the autophagy mechanism for their advantage. Since the effects of autophagy are varied between coronavirus types, it remains to be seen what are the effects of COVID-19. The safer attitude would be to avoid autophagy triggers at the first sign of infection. When healthy, though, autophagy should be helpful in preventing the disease. The problem is we probably won't know when we are first infected. There are 3 common ways by which anyone can trigger autophagy. 1. Fasting over 48 hours or more. 2. High intensity interval training. And 3. A low-carb diet with less than 10% of carbs, that is, the ketogenic diet. In previous videos, I have shown you my daily routine, so take a look at them by clicking the link on the top right corner of your screen. Although I do not fast for 48 hours, I do high-intensity interval training with my pyramid push-up routine. I do my training near the end of my daily 23-hour fast, before my one meal a day. Fasted exercise is ideal to generate autophagy. There are two biochemical pathways that you might hear about in the future. These are like the yin and yang of cellular homeostasis. Let's identify them here very briefly. 1. AMPK, that senses a decline in energy during fasting. In order to maintain energy homeostasis, AMPK promotes autophagy. Number 2. mTOR, which detects nutrient signals in the fed state. mTOR is a cell growth regulator that inhibits autophagy. To suppress autophagy, all you need to do is eat. Should we suppress or enhance autophagy? The benefits of autophagy for the immune system are tempered by the risk of helping the coronavirus replication. Fasting that exceeds 24 hours may give coronavirus a chance to take advantage of autophagy to replicate. OMAD and fasted exercise allow our bodies to take advantage of the benefits of autophagy for the immune system. We may have the ability to resist the virus infection before it occurs. Yet we may limit the duration of autophagy by eating our meal before the 24 hours are up. If we experience symptoms, we may stop OMAD or the fasted exercise or both and then determine if our health improves. How to prevent and treat the coronavirus disease is a medical issue, so I'm going to limit my comments about that. However, I will keep my one meal a day regimen, and I will keep you informed if I ever get infected with the COVID-19. In essence, I will be my own guinea pig, and I will keep a diary of my experiences if I show any signs. So far though, I've been just fine. While in quarantine at home, why not commit yourself to eat one meal a day for 21 days in a row? You should have plenty of time for fasted workouts, and cooking only once a day will free additional time. We might even avoid making too many trips to the supermarket. This might be the opportunity to develop a home business or a hobby. Perhaps contribute with your knowledge and experience with a YouTube channel of your own. I have been running my pathology consulting business at home since 1995. Now, OMAD contributes to my focus, and I hardly ever get sick. The quarantine may actually be a great opportunity for you to change your life, lose weight, become fitter, and resist the coronavirus infection. Knowledge is power. This is Juan Sarmiento reminding you that life is looking up.